Well, Rachel and I got ready to go over to the lot to work today, and it's actually raining. Rather a nice surprise.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll look at the transplants.
Yeah. Maybe it'll blow over and maybe it won't. So we'll see, I guess.
These guys are starting to come up. I was afraid they weren't. They just are a little pokier. These have got to be peppers. They look less fuzzy than tomatoes. And then we've got a few beets coming up, but not a lot to look at yet. Now, the reason I wanted to get out today was because these are yams. This is actually a pot filled with yams. All the yams that I dug and the smaller pieces and ones I cut, there's multiple different species in here. And they really, really need to get in the ground, but the weather has been way too dry until the last couple of days. And I actually came up with what I think is gonna be a good yam staking system. Check this out. Look at that. That is all yam vine climbing the wall right there. Isn't that crazy? That's like 10 foot of yam vine. It hasn't opened a single leaf on it yet. This one variety is pretty awesome for that. But it found the fig tree and it decided to just simply go all the way up the wall. This is why I need to get them in the ground. And today I got some staking materials, which I was going to show you, but we'll see if the rain lets up. Those don't look like lettuces.
No.
Maybe they're papaya?
Maybe, but, well, maybe they're zinnias.
Could be zinnias. Tomatoes?
Pineapples?
Oaks. Probably oaks.
Bougainvillea?
Yeah, might be bougainvillea. Looks a little bit more like West Indian locust.
Jackfruit.
Jackfruit, yeah, that's it. Almost 2 inches. Now, Crafty the barber said, I'd do better putting galvanized over this thing. If you could tell me what you're talking about, in a way that would be easy to put galvanized over here, let me know, because I like to do that. I feel like if I put galvanized over like this, it's just going to be blown over sideways. And if I have to build a structure to put galvanized on it, I don't know. You just explain it to me. Crafty, if you're watching, let me know. Got some compost slop here that I'll kind of pack in the corners here. The rain drove down some of the material that we put in here, so there's gaps. And I have a stopgap measure. These old hunks of coconut shell. I'm just gonna cram them in here. Somebody asked, why would I be putting a log in my compost? Well, the point of this is it's actually not. I'm composting in place, but this is a container garden. And what I'm doing is filling in the space so I don't have to use so much soil on top. And all this stuff will get used by the plants farther down. And I will just put a little bit of soil on top. Oh, there's a roach in there. You missed the roach, you weren't close enough. It would have been really exciting. Not as exciting as a giant centipede, but there you go. So I'm just gonna dump these in here and kind of fill up the space. There you can see a roach. There's a frog. See more? I don't know how that explains. These actually were from the bottom of another container garden I did, and they're all very rotten, but they're dry at this point, so there's not much to look at. But if I was going to plant root crops, I wouldn't do this like this, because you don't want the roots going down into all of it. Like if I was going to plant yams or something or something, I wouldn't do it. But with this, I'm just going to be planting, you know, beans and lettuces and herbs and whatever else. So I want to pack up the space and then put some soil on top of it, and then grow the gardens just like I did with the other one. It's a Hugel fridge. And it's a ready-to-go container garden. I didn't bring any water with me today, but hopefully we'll get some more rain, and it'll rain on this. Kind of pack it down into the cracks some, because it's gonna want to settle over time a little bit. And then we can plant it up. save you a lot of money this way. I would have had to put like 8 bags in here or something otherwise. And this way I can get away with a half a bag. Plus I'm making compost underneath. Here we go. Gorgeous. What do you think, Martha?
Okay.
So the other day, when Rachel mentioned that I was getting my head examined, it's because I have a bump on my head that's like right at the hat line and it's irritating to me. And so I'm gonna have a doctor fix it. So today I went out for the second time, third time. Yeah, today was the third time and I wasn't actually on the doctor's schedule for some reason. So I didn't get it fixed yet again. But what I did get was I got some rebar. And what's really cool, okay, I bought this rebar and I had it cut. These are 6-foot pieces. But we got out of the doctor's office and it's like, one of the things I was gonna do today is bring home rebar that I could use for stakes and hammer into the ground. And so we go past this dumpster and they were doing some work, some construction work, and they had thrown away a bunch of used rebar. So I got enough rebar to do a bunch of stuff. Plus I bought a few more big fat ones for the yam staking. But it was like God was just like, okay, David, you can have some free rebar. So I was like, thank you, God. I really appreciate the free rebar. It just was awesome, like perfect timing, because I was gonna get it anyway. So let's grab this rebar and I'll get it out and start working with it.
I'm just going past.
All right, so I was gonna be really clever and make this great looking, you know, reclaimed netting thing to grow cucumbers and beans and that sort of stuff on. So I grabbed this from the beach and I showed it on a previous video. But now that I'm unwinding it, it looks like a total wreck and it's not as wide as I would have hoped. So I've decided to just not bother with it. I think it's totally not worth it. And I just don't care enough. I'm gonna throw it away. Maybe I'll throw it back in the ocean. No, that's wrong. We don't do that.
Saving our planet is the thing to do.
Unlike the netting, this rebar, this reclaimed rebar, for the most part, is actually gonna be useful to me. And in a upcoming video, I will use it. But right now it's raining again. And I forgot my big hammer, so this is how day 12 ends.
On YouTube and make sure you recycle and make
reusable bags. I will never ever use plastic because ew, plastic. I adopted a whale. I'm gonna say something about climate change once I think of something to say that hasn't been said before. Carbon!